camels, they're very important in our culture. In fact, they're sort of like the stars of the show, right? We use camels for many different things. For instance, people do consume camel milk, right? And even here in the Twin Cities, you can find camel milk as well as camel meat because of the Somali community here. They're also used for transporting things, especially your traditional Somali house. You can take your traditional Somali house apart, and then you could place it on the back of the camel before you go on to another destination. In the southern portion of Somalia, people use this animal to make sesame seed oil, because it is a big machine that grinds the sesame seeds, and it needs a powerful animal. And Somalia, even to this day, continues to export camels to other parts of the world, especially to the Middle East. Camels, in the past, showcased how wealthy you were. The number of camels you had showed how wealthy and prestigious you were. In fact, you couldn't get married until you were able to give 100 camels to the bride's family. Even though people eat camel meat, they're very delicate with this animal. There is this particular saying that they would say to the camel before they place things on its back. What they would say to the camel is, hey, I'm not using you to haul things. Instead, what I'm doing is I'm covering you from the rain. Camels also appear in Somali folklore stories. When people looked at the night sky, what they saw was not Pegasus like the Greeks. What they saw actually was a camel, and it was a camel that was missing its hump. Right? And Somalis refer to it as the orca, irka, right? Or the male camel of the sky, right? And sometimes they would tease each other because that constellation looks like a camel that's missing its hump, right? So sometimes if a person is not very bright, they might say, oh, the hump fell from the sky and hit them in the head, and that's why they're not so bright.